Had him send his peace and blessings upon his life and final message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his family, his companions, and all those who follow his way until the day of judgment. So today, inshallah, we're going to be continuing with our discussions with a pretty light chapter, which is the i'rab of pronouns, or the i'rab of the lamed, or the grammatical states of pronouns. And that we'll get into that in just a moment. I just wanted to recap what we discussed last week and kind of solidify some concepts. Important concepts, okay? So last week we talked about ism al-ishara and ism al-mawsool. So these are two special types of isms that exist in the Arabic language that have special rules with them. And when it comes to ism al-ishara, you have masculine, feminine, then you have single, dual, plural, and then you have near or far. And for each of those different categories, you have a particular ism al-ishara. So if I want to talk about this, qalam, and it's near, what do I say? هذا قلم. But if I threw it over there and I pointed to it over there, what is it? ذلك قلم. Now, if I have a daughter with me and I have my daughter right here and I say this is my bib. So I say this is a daughter. What would I say? هذه بنت. Or هذه بنتي. Right? My daughter. If she was over there, I say تلك بنتي. Excellent. Now, if I'm talking about all of you, and I say it to all of you, and I'm speaking to somebody, and I indicate it to you, then I'm saying these people here, and I'm talking about males and females put together, what do I say? And I say these believers. هؤلاء المؤمنون. هؤلاء المؤمنون. Okay? But if I'm away and I'm pointing to you from far, and I'm saying أولئك المؤمنون. Okay? So it doesn't matter for plural, it doesn't matter if it's masculine, feminine, it doesn't matter. It's ha'ula'i for near, ula'ika for far. Okay? And we see this often in the Quran. Ula'ika humul muflihun. Ula'ika, those are, etc., etc. So ism al-ishara is pretty straightforward. Ism al-mawsool is a little bit more complex because it's one of those 12 plus phrases or fragments that I've mentioned before. Meaning it ties words together, it's a compound, it compounds words together. Connects words together. So ism al-ishara, I'm sorry, ism al-mawsool, the ism al-mawsool here is alladhi, alladhi. And either you're talking about single male, single female, or plural male, plural female. Okay? And the plural male, plural female is all the same. The plural male and plural female are two different ones. There's dual as well, but those are so uncommon in the Arabic language and also especially in the Quran that I don't have them there for the sake of completion in the chapter, but they're not important for you to know, okay? So, alladhi is referred to a single male. What's for a single female?
Allati.
Excellent, mashallah. If you're talking about plural male, what do you say?
Alladhina.
If you're talking about plural female, even this is very rare in the Quran. What is it? Allati, allati. So you just stretch allati, kind of like banat, bint, banat. Or mu'allima, mu'allimat. So think about it, it's very similar. But allati is very uncommon in the Quran. It's mainly allati, alladhi, and alladhina. Those are the three. If you remember those, bang for your buck, it'll make it most progress for you, inshallah. But the key thing to understand is how does it tie words together and what is its function in the sentence? And so we have two different examples here. I want you guys to tell me which one is correct and which one is incorrect and why. Okay? So we said, أُحِبُّ مُحَمَّدًا الَّذِي هُوَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ or أُحِبُّ مُحَمَّدًا الَّذِي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Which one is correct and which one is incorrect and why? Because it's a fundamental rule. So there's three parts of the ism al-mawsool, or the mawsool complex. What are the three parts of a mawsool complex? There are three parts. The first part is the word that comes before, alladhi. Then you have the actual ism al-mawsool. So this is the mawsool. This is the ism al-mawsool. Right? And then, what top one is right, the bottom one is wrong. How many of you guys agree with him? Raise your hand. The top is right, bottom one is wrong. Okay, excellent. Who wants to tell me why the top is right and the top is wrong, or the bottom is wrong? Go ahead.
Since that should be a full sentence.
Excellent. So the key rule here is the silla needs to be a full, complete sentence. Is Rasulullah a complete sentence? No. So again, it goes back to the reason why we needed to study the phrases first. So Rasulullah is what? What is it? Mudaf mudaf ilayh, or as a possessive phrase. Okay. Rasulullah, the messenger of Allah. And that's what Allah has a kasra on it. Because it is in what state?
Jah.
Excellent. So, this is how you turn. So, this is the correct one. Because huwa, Rasulullah, he is the messenger of Allah. So, he is the messenger of Allah. And so, you need to have a complete sentence. The silla needs to be a complete sentence. It can be a noun sentence, or it can be a verb sentence. So, jumlatun ismiya, or jumlatun fi'liya. So if you wanted to turn this into jumlatun fi'liya, you can change down here. So, uhibbu Muhammadan alladhi
three.
What are they?
Yes,
اسم
فعل
And each of these three types of words, either they do take grammatical state or they don't. And so there are three different possibilities. Number one, so grammatical states. Present tense verbs, they have a grammatical state. We'll study those later. Number one that we need to know is
Dhamirs.
The grammatical states of Dhamir. Huwa, huma, hum, hiya, huma, hunna. Anta, antuma, antum, anti, antuma, antunna. Ana, nahnu, nahnu. Hu, huwa, hum. Ha, huma, hunna. Ka, kuma, kum. Ki, kuma, kunna. Me, or the ya, and na. These are all Dhamir. They all are in this category, meaning they have a grammatical state, but they do not show that grammatical state. It's always huwa, no matter what its grammatical state is. It's always hum, no matter what its grammatical state, etc. Okay? And we'll find, actually, that they only take particular grammatical states in just a moment. Okay? Any questions about this? So this is very helpful, because whenever you see an ism, most of the time it's going to have grammatical state, and it's going to show its grammatical state. Either it's going to have the Dhamma, or Fatha, or Kasra, or the Ina, Una, or Atin, Atan, right? Either it's going to have one of those signs, because it's an ism. And present tense verbs, so a present tense verb is Yaf'aluna. Yaf'aluna is in the state of Rafa. What? How does it become the state of Nasa? Is you take away the Nun. It's yafa'alu. The Nun is gone. Okay? You'll learn that later. But the point is that present tense verbs can change the way they look based on its grammatical state. So these are important to know. These are also important to know. Every single harf, fi, min, ila, an, they don't have a grammatical state. You can't say that this arf, this is a rafa, this is nasa, this is a jah. No, they don't have a grammatical state. Fi, ila, an, ala, all these types of haruf, these do not have a grammatical state. And also past tense verbs. Fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'alat, fa'alna, etc. All these different verbs, they do not have a grammatical state. Okay? So as simple as that. So when you see them in a sentence, I say, hey, what's Ketabat? What is the grammatical state of Ketabat? What do you say? Alif doesn't have a grammatical state. That's it, you end it there. But if I say Tektubu, what's the grammatical state of Tektubu? Then you need to be able to answer it. You don't know it yet. Or if I say Muhammadan, you know, Uhibbu Muhammadan, what's the grammatical state of Uhibbu Muhammadan? You say Alif, this is the state of Nas. Why do you know it's the state of Nas? Because it has a Fatha on it. Why isn't it the state of Nas? Because it is the maf'ul bihi. So that's how you understand words. But if I say huwa Muhammadan, and I say what's the grammatical state of huwa, what would it be? Rafa. And I say, why is it in the state of Rafa? Because it is the
Mubtada.
Mubtada. It is the Mubtada of a jumlatul ismiya, right? How do you know it's in the state of Rafa? You don't have a sign. It's always going to be huwa. The only way you know it's going to be in the state of Rafa is because it has that function. Okay? So now, let's get to that so that you understand what I'm talking about. Everyone has this down? Okay. With that in mind, understanding this concept, it'll help you understand the concepts of grammatical states and pronouns. Why? Because there are two major rules of grammatical states of pronouns. Huwa, huma, hum, hiya, huma, huma, anta, antuma, antum. Is that number one, they do not show their grammatical state. Show their state. They don't show their grammatical state. Okay? They take the grammatical state, but they don't show it. Meaning, they don't have dhamma, kasra, fatha. They don't change their form. They look the same all the time. Okay? Number two, there are only two possibilities for a dhamir. There are only two possible grammatical states for a dhamir. Two. I'm sorry. Let's not make that rule. Detached pronouns have only two possibilities. Two possibilities. And attached pronouns have only two possibilities. comes to detached pronouns, there's one that's the most common, and there's one that we talk about as a special case. I'm going to tell you an example of huwa hamdu. Yeah, which means me, only me. Iyana, only us. But some of you say na'buduka wa na'buduhu wa na'buduha wa na'buduhum, all these different things. But when you say iyyaka na'budu, that's it. There's no continuation. Okay? Make sense? This is rarely found in the Quran, or very rarely found, but it is important to know because it is in the Quran. Okay? But the point is, when you see a detached pronoun, what are the detached pronouns? Huwa, huwa, hi, huwa, huwa, hum, hiya, huma, hunna, anta, antuma, antuma, anta, antuma, antuna, and then anna, anna. These are all detached. Whenever you see these, they can either be in the state of rafa or either in the state of kasra. And they are in the state of rafa because they are always the subject. They're always the subject. And remember, subjects are in the state of rafa. Okay? Either the subject of the verb or the subject of the noun itself. That's why they're in the state of rafa. Okay? So these are the two rules you need to know. Detached pronouns only have two possible grammatical states. Either they're in the state of rafa or they're in the state of nasl. Okay? And they're only in the state of nasl when you see them as part of the iyya construct. Okay? Iyyaka, iyyana. Okay? This whole thing is considered a detached pronoun. Okay? Alright, any questions about this? Go ahead.
When you bring something forward like this, is this called bringing the khabar forward?
No, it's not. Because it's not a khabar, it's the object of the verb. Khabar goes only with jumlatul ismiya. This is jumlatul fa'liya. Na'buduka is a jumlatul fa'liya. There is no khabar. There's only the fa'il, fa'il, maf'ul. The fa'il is the subject, maf'ulun bihi is the object. Okay? So it is bringing the object of the verb forward. Okay? And that's the only way you can do that. Yeah. Okay? Everyone has this down? Go ahead. The next example is attached pronouns. Attached pronouns is more simple. By the way, detached pronouns, okay, those are the only two possibilities. Majority of the time, rafa. So if you see a detached pronoun, it's rafa. Unless you see iya, you know it's enough. It's that simple. Huwa, huma, hum, hiya, huma, hunna, anta, antum, antum. Whenever you see that, it is in the state of rafa. Okay? It is in the state of rafa.
So in
the
state of nasab, only the ka we can see, or only the iya?
Iya, iya. The whole thing is a damir.
The whole thing?
Yeah, it becomes part of a special type of damir.
Oh, it's only with iya.
Iya, exactly.
Iya hu or iya ki. That's okay.
Exactly. Iya hu, iya ya, iyana. All, anything. You connect it, it becomes a special detached pronoun, and it is in the state of nasa.
That's nasa.
Okay?
Even if it's iya ki for a female, but it's nasa.
Exactly. And so that's that. But most importantly, whenever you see huwa, huma, hum, hiya, huma, hunna, anta, tama, to, you know it's in the state of nasa. Okay?
One visit up.
Always. Because it's always the subject. Okay? Everyone has this down? So now we have attached pronouns. What are the possibilities of attached pronouns? Ka, kuma, kum, ki, kuma, tunna, hu, ayna, hu, huma, hum, ha, huma, hunna. Attached, those are all attached pronouns. And by the way, we've already studied that, so that's why I'm not going to do that again. It's a separate chapter altogether. So attached pronouns. So who here? Who, whom, whom, ha, whom, hunna, ka, whom, whom, ki, whom, hunna, ni, na. These are all attached pronouns. There are only two possibilities with those as well. What are the two possibilities of attached pronouns? Jar. Excellent. MashaAllah. Jar. And what's the other possibility? Nasl. Excellent. Okay? Give me an example of a jar. There are two possibilities that makes an attached pronoun in the state of jar. The first one is simple. What are the two possibilities for anyone, for any word to become a state of jar? Hajar. So, fi. fihi, in him. So this word he is in the state of jar. Why? Because it follows half jar, fi. Minhu, minhum, minha, alayhi, alayka, anhu, anhun, anna, anni. All these follow half jar. And because of that, they take the state of jar. Make sense? The question is, why does this have a kasra? So I told you, pronouns don't change based on the grammatical state, right? So why sometimes we have minhu, and why is it fihi? You're out of your mind, man. It's changing its state. It's changing the way it looks. It never changes the way it looks in grammatical state, right? I didn't lie to you. So why is this? Why does it have a kasra? This is not a kasra because it is in the state of jar. It's a kasra because why? Anyone?
Speech. For speech.
For speech. So specifically what is happening here that makes it easier for speech? So when you're speaking this, it changes it for the smoothness of the conversation. Why is it changing? There are two reasons why.
The ya that comes before
it. Exactly. The ya. Because there's a ya that follows it, it'll change to a kasra. Okay? Because the ya follows it, it changes into a kasra. And so another example is what? Alayhi. Because it's a kasra, and there's a ya before it, it takes that kasra. The only other reason why it takes a kasra is because the letter before it also has a kasra. So give me an example. When a letter before it will have a kasra? Min huruf jar.
Bihi.
Exactly. So bihi. Bihi. So B has a kasra, so therefore that has also a kasra. Make sense? Excellent. There's only one other reason why an attached pronoun will take the state of jar. There's only one other reason why any word takes the state of jar.
Mudaf.
When it is the
mudaf.
Mudaf. Mudaf ilay. When it is the mudaf ilay. So if I want to say this is his book, hadha kitabuhu. Hadha kitabuhu. So the word kitabuhu. This is the possessor. This is called mudaf mudafu ilay. So who is the possessor? Mudafu ilay. And therefore it is in the state of jar. Even though it has a dhamma, because it never always has a dhamma unless it follows a letter that has a kasra, or unless it follows a ya. It'll always have a dhamma. Okay? So this is in the state of jar. Technically, we say that this is mabni. So if you want to be practical with it, you say, هَذَا الضَّمِيرٌ مَبْنِيٌ عَلَى الضَّمَّةِ. This is a dhamir that is, mabni means it doesn't change. It is grounded on the dhamma. The dhamma never changes. هَذَا الضَّمِيرٌ مَبْنِيٌ عَلَى الضَّمَّةِ عَلَى الضَّمِّي upon the dhamma, okay? فِي مَحَلِّي. It replaces the state of jar. Okay, that's the proper way of saying it. But for our purposes, I'm saying this is the grammatical state. Okay? Does that make sense? Any questions? Did I confuse anyone with that? I just want you to know that because when you hear this outside of this class, you understand what's going on. Okay? So technically this is mabni. So you're having a discussion with one of your friends in another class. You're like, oh man, this is mabni, man, what's wrong with you, right? And you're like, no, it takes a grammatical state, you're lying. It is technically mabni, but it's a special type of mabni. It is a mabni that is in the state of, it does have a grammatical state, but it doesn't show it, okay? And the reason, so because it does not show it, it's called mabni, okay? So all that aside, just know that this is in the state of jar. Okay? But it does not show its grammatical state. It doesn't change for its grammatical state. It stays the same no matter what. Because we're going to see here that it's also going to be nasl. Give me an example when an attached pronoun takes the state of nasl. Na'buduka. Excellent.
Inshallah.
Right? Na'buduka. But I'm going to use a past tense verb because we are familiar with past tense verbs. So, example is? So let's just use the past tense. What is the past tense verb of na'buduka? Any questions so far? Okay. So these are the two general rules in regards to this one right here. There are going to be some key rules that you can follow that will help you, inshallah. Key ideas. Everyone has this? Because, okay, you guys understand that one? I'm going to leave it out of these, okay? Because it's a special example, I'm not going to bother with it, okay? That's complex, that's a higher level. But you guys know it so that you know it, okay? But these rules are important. Number one, either it will follow if the pronoun is detached. It is rough. That's it. Okay? Okay? Just remember that. Huwa, huma, hum, hiya, huma, huma. All these detached pronouns are rough. That's it. Okay? Don't worry about iyyaka and all that stuff. Just you know what I'm talking about. Okay? Number two. Now, so detached pronouns are all rough. Okay? Huwa, huma, huma. If you see that, it is rough. Okay? If it is attached, so attached pronoun, attached to an ism, what is its grammatical state? Equals?
Jar.
Jar. Excellent. If it is attached to a fi'l, what is it? Go ahead and take a 5-minute break, inshallah, as you're running this down. blessed so-and-so person. So, and now.
If you just want to use this word, right?
Yes.
If you want to use the same concept.
So halaqa in and of itself already has an object. It already requires an object. So he created something, right? So you don't say akhlaqa. Akhlaqa doesn't have to make any sense. Because the verb itself already entails an idea that someone's performing the action and someone's receiving the action. You understand? But if you want to turn that into passive, he was created, khuliqa. Khuliqa. Inshallah. For 10 minutes. طيب, so we're going to do some practice now, inshallah. So go ahead and turn to page 59. Okay, so this is just a review. What are the detached pronouns here? Detached pronoun in Arabic is ضمير المنفصل. الضمير المنفصل. What is attached? Muttasil. Muttasil, okay? Just so you know. So, we're going to go through this chart together. So, huwa.
Hiya.
Behind you. I didn't get your name. What's your name? Abdurrahman. You know what the next one is? Page 59. My book. Kitabi, excellent. And Kitabuna, Excellent. All right, Saad, fill in the appropriate pronoun given the meaning of the possessive construct. Hint, hint, hint. Place a male or female after the pronoun indicating if it is a masculine or feminine if needed. So, vimithvihi, give me the meaning of this. He, the word he is what's supposed to be placed in the empty box. So what is he? Oh, the only one you're not sure about? Okay. Okay, so he is equivalent to who, but the reason why it's he is because it has a kesra before. Exactly. Next, bi qalamikum.
What was that?
With his likeness. Single masculine. Third person. Biqalamikum. Your pen? Single, dual, or plural? Plural. Biqalamikum with your pen. Excellent. Biidnihim. Should be a kesra there. So change that from a dhamma to a kesra. Why? Anytime you have a kesra before it, you have a kesra on the hand. Okay?
What's that?
Bi'idni hinna. Should be hinna, not hunna. So it is with their permission, female plural. Excellent.
Why hinna? Because of the B?
Hinna because the letter before the ha has a kesra. So it's for pronunciation. Okay. Bisiyaratiki. Bisiyaratiki. With your feminine car. So siyaki is you female. Okay? Your car. So you're talking, this is all these are mudaf mudaf alayh. His car, your car, his, etc. Okay? Next. Biqadrihim. Louder, they're loud over there.
Plural
masculine, so what is it? With? With their power. Excellent. Yeah. Abdul Rahman, you want to give it a try, or you're trying to catch, just, you want to observe it? So go ahead, Deborah Mehta.
Be
Maggie. Mad.
Be Maggie. With my wealth.
With my wealth. Excellent. MashaAllah. Asif. Be Lisanina.
With our
tongue. Excellent, mashallah. Bi Rasulika. Naveed.
With your messenger.
Excellent. Your single male. Brother Asif in the back, do you want to give it a try? You also want to observe. You're going to take a break, I think. Sister. Now, fill in the appropriate pronoun, giving the meaning of the verb that precedes it. Okay? So now, what kind of state will these attached pronouns be in? Nasa. Why they follow the verb? Okay, excellent. So, khalaqakum, he created you all. Next. Faraz. Katabakunna. He wrote. That makes no sense, but anyways. Just practicing the verb.
You all feminine.
You all feminine, right? Oh god, I must have been tired. okay, excellent. So you all female, okay?
This set apart.
No, it doesn't.
So you translate you wrote to you?
Yeah, it would be kataba ilaykunna. Yeah, that would be more appropriate. I'm sorry?
It's like parking books.
Yeah, he wrote to you. We're not going to give you better. Okay, so qara'a.
So it means he wrote to you?
No. Just ignore this one. It doesn't make sense. I'm sorry? Kataba lakum. So it would be kataba lakunna. So this doesn't make sense in and of itself, okay? Qara'a. He read. That's more appropriate than he read him, right? Okay, excellent. Next, Barabahuma. Huma. So it's who, whom, whom, ha, whom, hunna. What is it? Louder. Those two, exactly. Darabahuma, he hit those two. Next, allamakuma. He taught you two. Excellent. Next, akalaha. He ate it. So, when would you see ha? Again, single, female. Probably talking about multiple non-animate objects. Okay, hopefully he's not eating an actual female. That's like disgusting. Jeffrey Dahmer in here, right? So akalaha, like he ate all the food, right? Akalaha, okay? Next, dafa'ani. Dafa'ani, he defended me. Now, one thing that's interesting is that when, I want to point this out real quick. Everyone has this down. So, and this is what you're going to see commonly. If the single, if you're talking about me, and I'm talking about my book, for example, if it's followed in isr, that dhamir, attack dhamir, for me, if it follows in isr, it is just a yeah, okay? So, qalami. Qalami. Just a yeah. But if it follows a fi'il, you have to put a noon before it, okay? So,
also the ba, so
not the ba. The ba changes qadr to the state of jar. Qadri, the ri is because ba, okay? But the him is in the state of jar because it is the mudafun ilay of qadr. Okay? Qadr. Excellent. MashaAllah. Huwa, Naveed, what grammatical state is it? Always. I'm sorry? Excellent. Rafa. MashaAllah. Sister, ضرب هما هما. It is. Nasab, excellent. Why is it nasab? Simple answer.
Attached to the fact.
Yes. Complicated answer. A little bit more complex. What happens when it's attached to the fact? What is it?
It's attached. Object.
It's the maf'ul bihi. It's attached to the verb. So it's the object of the verb, just like you said. It's the object of the verb. So because it's the object of the verb, it is in the state of nasab. Excellent. Bi mali. Mali. The ya. What is its grammatical state? Ja. Why? Simple answer, complex answer. Simple answer, because it is attached to a ism. Complex answer. So what happens because it's attached to an ism? What is its function? It is the mudafun ilay. Mudafun ilay. It is the possessor of mal. Okay, the mal belongs to me. Next, dafa'ani. Now we're repeating the verb, but what is its grammatical state? Nasl. Simple answer. Complex answer. Why?
Simple answer because it's a
fifth. Exactly.
Complex answer is a fourth.
Simple answer, it's nasab because it is attached to a fi'l. If you say that for me, alhamdulillah. But I really want you to know why, because it's attached to a fi'l, it's in the state of nasab because it is the object of the verb. Okay? Excellent. Next, antum. You all. Anytime you see a detached pronoun, it is rafa. Excellent. Bikum. Excellent. Bikum. Kum is jar. Because it is the majroor of bi, which is a harf jar. Okay? Innaha. Nasab. Why? Simple answer, complex answer. So it's attached to a harf nasab. The complex answer is because it is the ism inna. Okay? Excellent. Now, chapter 11, I would like to go over these. So, page 65. Get together in groups if you can. How many groups do we have? Try to put the sentences together, okay? Next five minutes, sentences, put these sentences together in Arabic.
Which page?
If you need help with an Arabic word, let me know, inshallah. Page 65. So everyone in the back, get together. Everyone in the front, get together, inshallah. And then, sister, I'm sorry. I'm sorry? By the way, every single verb that's in the present tense, change it to the past tense, okay? Because you don't know present tense verbs. Sorry? Yeah, the considered big, don't put considered big, just put, get rid of the consider. I don't know who made that one, that wasn't me. So the first sentence is, I lived in the house, the one which is big, okay? I'll give you guys 10 minutes because it's really challenging your thought process. But again, if you need an Arabic word, let me know, inshallah. Yeah. Lost is a taraka. Well, lost here in this context means hasar. Hasar. Lost is hasar. The past tense. So for example, she is the student, the one who knows a lot. Say the one who knew a lot. The verb. Because the order of this chapter is after present tense verbs. We haven't, we changed the order. I'm sorry, you're right, it needs a harf, it needs ila. Sajida needs ila.
Sajida needs ila?
It's prostrate too.
Oh, bait, fil bait.
I'm sorry, it needs lam. So sajida li.
Lilla.
Lilla.
Study means qara?
Study is talaba. Or you study with the teacher. So ta'allam. I'm sorry, ta'allam, you're right. Ta'allam.
Ta'allam.
Ta'allama is he studied. So how do you say you studied? You're close. You studied. Some of this is challenging stuff, languages that you don't know yet. So, inshallah, hopefully, you'll benefit from learning it afterwards. How are you guys doing? You guys working together, or everyone's like doing their own thing?
Chapter.
Speak up. Speak up. No, everyone together.
I can't help this.
Yeah, that's fine, but listen to the thought process, inshallah. What's the verb for protect?
Hafiza.
Rahima. Mercy is Rahima.
Taza.
Change the ending for the appropriate pronoun, for the appropriate subject.
Are you all working individually?
Well, I am asking them.
Who needs the word? Who needs the word?
I need.
Vote a friend. What word do you need?
I need dislike.
Dislike is kariha. Makroh, something's makroh, dislike, kariha. While you guys are at speed, okay, I'll give you guys another 3 minutes.
So, what will be the word for four? Four is lamb. Ilal is lamb or...
What's the sentence?
Four.
Ila is towards. You're moving towards something. Li is for. Purpose. What's the word?
The merciful to me. So it's Rahima is past tense. Now, you don't need kana. Unless you want to say jumlat ismiya, if you want to say kana rahiman li, you can say that too, but there's a verb, simpler sentence. Because kana is not used for jumlat ismiya. Kana is used for jumlat ismiya. Remember, it comes in the beginning of jumlat ismiya, it changes the mubtada and the khabar, it's mansub and marfu'. Old school Arabs like to use jumlat al-fi'liya more than jumlat al-ismiya. So whatever you can, that's probably preferred. All right, bismillah, everyone, attention, attention, come back. So each group, I'm going to ask you to give me your sentence. I'll write it on the board. And then we can debate whether it's right or wrong. So the first sister, inshallah, I lived in the house, sister's first, right? I lived in the house, the one which was big. The one which is big, okay? Is big. Yeah. So go ahead and tell me what your sentence is.
إلى الله
small thing though. And I'm not going to dock you actually for this.
It is subjective.
You said subjective, and I changed it actually for you. So this sentence is wrong. The actual verb is subjective, okay? And really, it's just guesswork. You just need to know whether the second letter has a customer or not. So that's why I'm not going to dock you on that, because you just need to memorize that. So that's not important. What's important to get everything else right. So, man, writing is horrible. We write it better.
If we write lilat, then.
Oh, yeah. So that was the other thing. I missed it. Sorry. So, gentlemen. Ilallahi. Ilallahi. Alladhi. I'm going to put it in. Alladhi. Excellent. So what is it? Eyewitness, those players, the ones who lost, okay?
I guess at the end, could we also just write from Khasimun and just put Al-Ladina Khasimun? But that would be another verb. Or do you have that option?
Let's find out. Okay. The first thing I want to correct you is, just for the sake of time, it's not Khasiru, it's Khasiru, okay? So, Khasiru.
Oh, yes.
Okay?
I pronounced it.
Khasiru. Okay? Alright, good. So, Because it is the ones who lost. Alladhina hum khasirun, what would the proper translation of that be? The ones who are losers. Okay? Okay? So the ones who lost indicates it's a past tense verb. Therefore, this is the better one. Okay? Alladhina khasirun. So let's check everything out. Shahidtu ulaika al-la'ibina alladhina hum alladhina khasirun. Anyone disagree with this? Shahidtu ulaika al-la'ibina alladhina khasirun.
Should be shahidtu, right? Shahid is a noun.
Shahidtu.
Yeah, we have shahidtu.
You have shahidtu?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's even more wrong. So the actual verb is shahada. Shahada, shahid. Okay? It's not shahida. It's shahada. Okay? So that's wrong. Shahada is the verb. And it's a verb, it is what is called an enhanced verb. The original four three letters is shahida. To see something or to witness something else is shahada. Okay, shahada. Yushahidu. So it's shahada, 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 shahadu. Shahadat, shahadata, shahadna, shahidna. Okay? Shahidtu, shahidtuma, shahidtum. Shahidta, shahidtuma, shahidtum. Shahidtu, shahidti, shahidtuma, shahidtunna. Shahidtu, shahidna. Okay? Shahidna. So just know that, okay? So shahidtu. Okay?
This is shahid. Shahid.
Okay?
With Alif?
Alif. Shahidtu. Okay? It's a verb that you're going to learn later, okay? Ulaika. Excellent. Those. Ulaika la'ibun. La'ibin. Excellent. It's la'ibin, not la'ibun, because it is the object. This whole thing is the object of the verb. So excellent job by that. So shahidtu ulaika la'ibin al-ladina khasirun. Excellent job, inshallah. Number four. The group in the back, everyone together. Who's your spokesperson? Asif. So, you studied with the female teacher, the one who was merciful to me.
Darasti ma'a al-ustadati allati rahimatni.
So, just one at a time so I can hear you. What is it?
Darasti.
Darasti.
Ma'a or ba or bin.
Okay, ma'a. Okay, excellent.
Al-ustadati.
Al-ustadati, excellent. It's a new word, by the way. Al-ustadati. Okay.
Al-ladhi.
One more time.
الذي
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 رحمتني
Darastu bil kitab. I studied with the book. Okay? You need that book to you use that book to perform that action. But the proper word here is ma, which means to be with. To be with that teacher when you were studying. Okay? So that was a good guess. That was actually a question someone asked earlier. Is it be or is it ma? The proper one here is ma. Okay? But that's a good guess as well. That's a good try as well. And so by the way, I said ta'allama, that's one word, but this is better because we've only learned these type of verbs. So daras, okay, darasa is better to study. Ta'allama means to learn. So it's similar, but darasa is better, okay? So excellent job. Darasti is it you male or you female?
You female.
You female. And so this is actually proper like etiquette of Islam too, right? Darasti ma'am stability, right? With the female teacher. That's good. Excellent job, guys. MashaAllah. Go ahead and write these down, and then I'll reach you and go to the next examples. So write down the proper versions. We have two more. Everyone has a top two at least? You have a top two? Or you need to write them? Sakantu fil bayt alladhi huwa kabir. سجدت لله الذي حفظني. سجدت لله الذي حفظني. سجدت لله الذي حفظني. Okay. Who's next? Sister? Five. So the next sentence is, she is the student. The one who knows a lot. And so the one who knows a lot is a verb, okay? Preferably. But you can say it in a different way. Yes, here, here. So she is the student. What's the last one? By the way, because it is the student, it would be he al-taliba. Al-talibatu al-lati, etc., etc. Okay? Hiya al-taliba with alif lam, because it's the. So Allah does not dislike, is a double negative, wonderful. Anyone who works for Islam. This is something that, and we want to do it in the past tense. Allah did not dislike anyone who works for Islam. Okay, so you don't know how to do negatives yet, unless you do. So who does? Go ahead. How do you say past tense, by the way?
How do you say past tense?
Yeah, so go ahead and do your sentence. So, ma actually is also a going to say,
it's also used for anyone, right?
Ahad means only one.
Like for example, is there a word called Mahakana Muhammad bin Abba Ahad?
That's correct. That's correct, yeah.
The Ahad then means anyone?
Ahad means anyone. Okay.
So we can't use it there. It's like anyone can use Ahad.
Yeah, so you can say, Makara Allah al-Ladi. So, Makara Allahu Ahadan. Yeah, but مَكَرَ اللَّهُ أَحَدًا الَّذِي etc. 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 Allah does not like anyone, the one who etc. etc. So مَكَرَ اللَّهُ أَحَدًا الَّذِي etc. etc. Allah does not like dislike anyone. But it would not be proper to use in this case because it's saying that Allah does not like does not dislike anyone. So then so it would be I don't know if that would be correct or not. I have to think about it for a second. Okay. Hamza, Ha, and Dal. Ahad. So, I'll think about that in a while. Okay, any questions? You guys did an excellent job, by the way. As, mashallah, I'm surprised. No, I'm not surprised. You guys have a great teacher. I'm just kidding.
There's no doubt you're going
to So, next week, inshallah, we'll be meeting same time. The two homework assignments I told you, chapter 18 and 19. Okay? 18 and 19. Write it out and give it to me because it's kind of a test type of thing for you guys, okay?
For next week?
For next week. Okay, we're not going to go over the answers. I'm going to send you the answer sheets next week, but I want to kind of assess where you guys are at, okay? JazakAllah khair, subhanAllah, wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.